of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Clerk, please call the roll. Burgess.
Here.
Jones.
Here.
Myers.
Here.
Davidson. Washington, Williams Bay.
Here.
Washington, Dallas.
Here.
Davidson.
All right, move to public comment. All questions and comments from the director will be given 3 minutes of comment. Each speaker will be allowed one opportunity to speak. Would you come to the mic, if you would just come check, make sure I have green lights on. And then, go ahead.
You just killed me.
Frank Williams, 1633 to 1616. Last I was in Cuba, born downtown, saying that I went down there to do something to the people in the village. I didn't go down there. Well, what went down there for? Because I am a member of the Friday evening seniors activity. That's what I was down there for. When we went down there, we was accused of being discrimination. The one that accuses is not here tonight. So when she asked her, was she ever denied any access to the building, or was she ever discriminated against ours? She said no. And then when he asked her, says, well, would you like for Frank to be the one that come in on Friday with you, or Wednesday with you guys? She says no. So she called somebody else, and he said, well, I can't do it during the summer, so Frank would have to do it. He said, well, she said, well, okay to that. I wish he was here, because we didn't go down there for that. What it is that Rose Langston did not put that in place. That was put in before Rose Langston did it. It was put in by another person that was sitting over here as the village manager at the time. And so that's who put that in place. The second thing is that I looked at Facebook or something, and Joe Wiswater had put out there about what Rose and Debbie and everybody been doing, going to Washington and things like that. I would like for him to prove to me that my wife and my daughter have took a dime from anybody in this village to do anything, travel to do anything else, anywhere in this village. Stand here and prove to me that she has been doing it for 2 years now. If you have anything, stand up here and prove. We told them 100 times they can't. She didn't take no money from nobody or did a thing else. The second thing is this. He keeps talking about what they can and cannot do. My daughter is sitting on a seat right now with Joe Wiswater, was a trustee. She lasted 3 terms. He couldn't even last 1 term. So what I want to say is starting right now. I wish he would stop doing it because it began to make me a little bit upset and to keep lying about the same thing. But if he have any proof that she did it, then here's the time to stand right here and prove it to me. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Anyone else?
Over here.
Yes, ma'am.
Over here.
Judy Cast here. Before I ask my questions, I would like to ask Mr. Mayor, you knew about this meeting well in advance. You put stuff on the agenda and know what's coming up. Therefore, again, I'm asking, with the questions that I have, the financial person should be here. And I want to know why, again, when you have pertinent stuff that needs to be answered, why Mr. Mohan is not here, why department heads are not here. I think it's very selfish and underhanded that we can't ask pertinent questions and get an answer right now. You're going to vote tonight. I want my questions answered tonight. And those questions are, what is the dollar amount of the tax levy that you intend to put on us tonight. How much was it last year? And what is the percentage increase? And those are my three questions.
Okay, we'll see if we get these answered for you before we vote on it. Yeah, I got most of them inside the ordinance when we do that, but do you have anything else?
No.
Okay. Give me the answers before we vote. Give me those answers before we vote. Yes.
Before I begin, I want to get some clarification on the rules to speak.
Okay. Hear me now?
I just want to get some clarifications on the rules to speak. I want to speak on behalf of someone who else has my own comment. I don't know if it's that I have a correspondence. That correspondence, you have the same allotted 3 minutes, or is it?
Yeah.
It doesn't say allotted 3 minutes.
3 minutes.
Okay. But if I have a comment myself, is that?
That would be included in your 3 minutes.
Okay. And can I ask the clerk just to tell me what's a minute and a half?
I sure will.
All right. I'm reading a letter on behalf of Barb Darman, Editor-in-Chief of the Southland Voice, and it reads as thus. Mayor David Hanks, on November 18th, I had the wonderful opportunity to participate in the celebration in honor of the veterans in Sauk Village. As it is a cause that is near and dear to my heart, I gladly take time to show support at any time that I am available, and the Veterans Day ceremony in Sauk Village is no exception. I took a brief opportunity near the close of the ceremony to inform a couple of veterans, of an upcoming Thanksgiving dinner that was being provided by Sauk Village. I was taken aback and offended when I was quickly called out for solicitation of the paper. What took me back further was the verbal expletives that were used in an expression of uncalled for anger. Had there still been a great concern in the sanctity of the ceremony, I would have understood, but I will not stand for abhorrent behavior, for the language, nor for public humiliation. It has been an honor to be part of this community by bringing forth information of the town and board to its residents. I will continue to bring forth the news as it happens in this town by all of its representatives. I am bringing forth this to you to make you aware that some members of the board are engaging in unflattering and unbecoming behavior that is, as a friend of this community, beyond offensive, especially to someone that holds the best interests of its veterans and Sauk Village near the
heart.
I will share a copy to this letter if you guys want to. That was an abridged version. My next concern is some of the members of the audience, possibly on the board, may have known that on December 2nd, in Oakland, California, 36 people perished in a residential warehouse fire. And I'm going to read a quote from one of the DJs who was present at the evening who survived the fire because he went out to have a cigarette smoke. It was on the Today Show, and he said this in tears. It was hell. We just had to watch the exit for hours and just wait. They never came out. And I know some of you may be wondering why I mentioned this, but my heart was heavy, and I'm sure everyone in the nation was, and we heard this news. And it kind of, we should, as we mourn and grieve for the lost, we should really humble ourselves in that we're in a prime position to prepare for any future disaster or any loss of life or any fires. According to the Federal Emergency Management Agency, winter is the time when residential fires increase. And luckily, thanks to Trustee Myers, in 2015 and so far this year, we've had no loss of life. And to show the gravity of this, 36 people, there are about 30 of us here now. And there are, that means that 30 of us here now, that means 6 of us would have to perish. So I hope that hits home, and I hope that you will join me in sharing information that is available from the U.S. Fire Administration Department under the FEMA. That website is usfa.fema.gov. And I really hope that we can join together and we can have a wonderful and blessed holiday. And we can join together to prevent any loss of life. We can have a very safe holiday with our family. Thank you very much.
I just basically want to reiterate the question that was asked today. Right. Once again, you know about the meeting, and its users are here. All the department heads were here. All of a sudden, you decide to cut that out. Now, I want to know exactly why, and I'm tired of hearing the excuse where you decide to let the trustees talk to them. I believe y'all have a better reason than that. Like she said, there's some questions that need to be asked and answered to. You know, they deserve an answer. You know, they're taxpayers. They have a right to know. They live in this village. They've been living here for years and years and years. They ought to have a right to know. So there ought to be a better answer than if you decide to let your trustees talk to them.
Mary Clark, I was here on Veterans Day, and in response to what was said about our government interrupting the service, my dad is a veteran. He was here. He was one of the ones that she went up and spoke to, and she scared half to death because he was focused on the ceremony, not wanting to be interrupted by someone he had no idea who it was, why she was showing him this information or anything else. She could have easily handed out the papers out in the hall as veterans entered into Toronto. There was no need, in my opinion, for her to interrupt veterans from a ceremony that every one of them signed on the dotted line, willing to sacrifice their life, and she takes it upon herself or whoever to interrupt, to promote an event. My father was very offended that she did that.
Pat Couch, I just have a question for the mayor. All the people that are running for office in the election have filed their papers, I understand. I'd like to know, what does it cost to file when they want to
challenge
is the word I'm looking for. When they want to challenge these petitions, what does it cost to do that? These folks have done their due diligence. They have their names. They have the people on their signatures. Let's let the election run for itself. Let these folks do their job. They are running for an office. Let the votes fall where they may. And let's run a clean election and let the people who are voted for win or lose. But the challenges, if you put up a challenge, who pays for that and how much does it cost? Just for food of thought.
Challenges can range depending on how many challenges there are. I think two elections ago, there was a bunch of challenges. It cost the village approximately $20,000. So again, that's the taxpayers. Again, when you have to have the hearings, there has to be attorneys, there has to be court recorders. That's all expensive taxpayers. So again, it depends how many challenges and stuff there are. No quote me on that, I just remember the 20-some thousand. So we can look into it or go back and find out. But it does get kind of expensive, especially if you have multiple hearings. That means multiple times when attorneys have to come out, multiple times the court recorders have to come out. I know there's lots of talk about the department heads. You know, the important department heads are here, and the safety. I know the chief's offering has been here tonight. But I've got assistant chief who's going to give the report tonight from Trustee Myers. When it comes to questions that the trustees should have, trustees all have the opportunity to meet with department heads, find out their answers. They should come prepared for the meetings. And I've heard before from the residents, trustees shouldn't be voting on something if they don't know what they're voting on. What's important is that they know what they're voting on, and they should be told. I just want to go off real quick here on last minute minutes, on the meeting minutes. The tax levy for tonight is, let's see, the total amount to be collected for tax levy for the current fiscal year is $2,327,870.36. The formula is 0.7% of an increase. That is less than it was last year. I think last year was 0.8%. So the tax levy this year is less than what it was last year.
So,
let's see here, $2,327,870.36. All right. Seeing no one else up there, we'll go to, of course, department heads, committees, commissions. We have Fire Department 911 Commission. I know Trustee Myers, do you have a report tonight?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The chief asked me to read his report tonight. Over the past 4 weeks, the fire department responded to 32 calls. They include 6 vehicle accidents, 4 lift assists, 2 gas leaks, 1 auto lead, 8 automatic fire alarms, 5 sealed alarms, 1 stove fire, 1 smoke alarm, 1 smell of gas, natural gas, 1 assist to the other agency, a smoke investigation, and a change of quarters to University Park, and down power lines, and 3. Chief also liked me to read the statement to the residents. With the cold weather upon us, make sure to check on the elder and your neighbor. When the weather is very cold outside, let the cold water drip on the faucet. That will save the pipes from freezing. Running water through a pipe will add, even a small trickle will stop it from pipes from freezing up solid. We recommend you set the thermostat at the same temperature during the day and night. And I'd like to wish each and every one of you a very wonderful Merry Christmas. And he asked me also, once again, to ask the residents in town, and if you know someone, please encourage them not to heat the house with a kitchen stove. We've been responding to quite a few of these, and the CO that will produce a high level of CO, and when you fall asleep, you do not know that you're going to be affected with it, and it can be very deadly to you. So once again, remember before you try to heat your house with a stove, it's better to get an electric heater and heat it up and use these gas stove to produce carbon monoxide. And that's all I have, Mr. Mayor. Thank you.
Thank you. Move to Police Department, Chief Lawson.
Mr. Mayor, trustees, from the last meeting, the department had 79 arrests and a total of 1,314 calls of total service. Case of note, on November 10th, officers were called to the 1900 block of 221st Street. The victim said individuals damaged his rental vehicle, which was parked in a driveway. The victim thought it was his brother who damaged the vehicle since he had recently had an argument with him. The victim provided a description of the offender vehicle, which was located with the offender as well as others in the vehicle. All subjects were taken into custody. Detectives were able to secure charges on the 3 offenders involved in a case for criminal damage to the vehicle. On November 16th, officers took a report from an individual who reported a credit card had been stolen. Just the season for stolen credit cards. When the officers contacted the credit card company, it was determined that the card was actually used in a neighboring town. Investigating this further, detectives found the victim was trying to defraud the credit card company and had knowledge of the person using the card. Charges of fraud were secured against the victim. And on December 5th, the victim of Domestic Violence Act contacted police to report her ex-boyfriend was stalking her. Upon arrival, the police, the ex-boyfriend offender fled from the scene. The offender was driving at a high rate of speed from the area, losing control and getting into an accident. The victim identified the offender who was injured in the accident, taken into custody. That victim the offender was transported to the hospital for injuries sustained in the accident. Charges for stalking were approved, as well as intimidation charges, since the offender persistently called the victim while he was at the hospital, trying to get the victim to drop the charges. The vest grant officers were recently measured for their vests, which should arrive in 4 to 6 weeks. Once we receive the vests, the receipts will be submitted for reimbursement to the Office of Justice Programs, Department of Justice. On a happier note, the police department was invited to participate in a Christmas parade. It was a great event. The officers enjoyed it. And I want to thank Trustee Jones and the Parks and Recreation Committee for the invitation to participate. Today, the Sauk Village Policemen's Association, a special thank goes out to the association who gave the police department $1,000 for the Shop with the Cop program. The department is very grateful for this and all donations, because the money will help plenty of deserving families to have a very Merry Christmas. And lastly, we also received a grant from Enbridge. The police department received a $2,000 community investment grant for Shop with a Cop. So there'll be plenty of happy children. That's the end of my report.
Thank you, Chief. Move to reports of officers, got the mayor's report. Just want to run through some of this real quick. First of all, last 2 weekends, we've had a lot of snow on the weekends. I'd say thank you to the Public Works employees for all the work they've done to make sure the roads are clear. If you listen to the weather, we're talking about a potential another snow outbreak hitting us again this weekend, so I tell everyone to be careful on the roads. Also, be careful about the cold front that's coming in. If you haven't felt it already, I guess you'll feel it again a little bit more tomorrow in the next few days. Make sure you check on your neighbors. If you have any seniors, if you have any elderly that you know, take this opportunity to stop in and check on them and make sure that everything's okay. Second, I'd like to let the board know, received a letter from Kurtz. See if I can go down here. We want to cooperatively thank you for your loyalty and gain. Again, we'll be donating $100 to the Illinois Fire Safety Alliance, the organization that organizes and operates Camp IME, more commonly known as Burn Camp. They are putting this in on behalf of the village, the Sauk Village. So they're doing this for all their communities that they work for. So Sauk Village is one of the ones that they're doing. So just let the board know on that. Thirdly, tonight you'll see on there that there is an ordinance for an expense reimbursement policy. Last Tuesday night at the end of the meeting, I informed the board that Springfield passed a mandate on municipalities that as of January 1st, you have to have a policy. I gave you a sample policy. What I did was I sent our current policy to the village attorneys and took what IML sent. And what you see before you tonight is what the attorney sent back with a recommendation to pass tonight, so at least we're in compliance on January 1st. If the board does not choose to pass it, needless to say, we won't have an expense policy in January 1st. It's up to the board if you want to look at it into the new year. But again, remember, an ordinance can always be amended. So it gives us at least the opportunity to at least get the ordinance that is acceptable from Springfield, so that we can continue having an expense policy in the case that any of our employees need to have anything expensed. Let's see here. Next, I'd like to say thank you to the Beautification Committee for all the beautiful work. You all saw the decorations up here, the Christmas tree in the lobby, and the small Christmas tree over here, lights and things hanging up, so making it very festive. Thank you very much for all the hard work and all the ones that volunteered to come out and put the decorations up. And then lastly, I'd just like to wish everyone a Merry Christmas, and hope everyone has a good time with their family and friends. And just remember the reason for the season. With that said, we move to Village Clerk, Stephanie Williams.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. First of all, I'd like to say, I know the weather is brutally cold, but we are not canceling Carol's Coke no more. We're going to continue to have Carol's Coke no more. Starts at 6:30, Trustee Williams, looking forward to more.
Is it on that? Yeah. I'm sorry. Okay, I'll reiterate. I know the weather is brutally cold, but we will still be hosting Carol's Cove one more on Thursday night. It starts at 6:30. Trustee Williams-Begg will report more on that event.
I will say, however, that we plan on opening the doors as early as 5:30. We won't be starting until 6:30, but we will open the doors sooner. So that's the first thing. And second of all, I just wanted to say there was a lot of discussion last week that I wasn't a part of the back and forth, and I'm kind of glad I wasn't. I'm going to really touch very lightly on some of the things that were said, because I personally don't believe that personal and political attacks should take place at a board meeting. But I will touch on a couple of things. First of all, when it comes down to the litigation with Ms. Houston, and it is litigation, as a public official, we're not even supposed to really speak about litigation until it's at a conclusion. There is a settlement agreement in process, but it is not concluded. So just to lightly touch on some of the things that was said about that, the fact that I was called downtown to represent the village was not my choice. I am often called as the village clerk to represent the village in litigation. As a matter of fact, I asked not to be the one to go, for a number of reasons, but most importantly, because I had a fundraiser that night. So the fact that I had to go down there, I was told it was because I'm familiar with the policy and procedures of Sauk Village. So that's why I did go. And while I was down there, because I knew the policy and procedures of Sauk Village, I was able to secure the settlement agreement between Ms. Houston and Mr. Williams was there on behalf of the Senior Friday Activity Group. And that agreement is now currently being drafted by the village attorneys. So just know that it was stated that I'm trying to keep people from the senior center. That is that is absolutely false. I have always supported the fact that that organization and any organization have full use of the senior center. So I just want to clarify that. Second of all, we talked about agendas last week. I also agree that agendas should not come out at the last minute. I also agree that all the supporting document should be ready for all trustees by Friday. I have been fighting for that the entire time I've been clerk. I start my agendas on Wednesday morning. It takes a lot to put an agenda together. It's not just the clerk putting an agenda together. It's the village attorney, the village engineer, the village manager, the department heads, the mayor, the trustees, and anybody who has input on something that needs to be discussed on that Tuesday. So note this, okay? I'm starting in January. I will make an effort to make sure that everybody turns their information in on Friday. I will make an effort to make sure that the agenda is posted on Friday. But however, know this. A lot of things do happen between Friday and Sunday. Look for amended agendas to come out before 7 o'clock on Sunday. I can't control that. If I don't have everything I need to put an agenda together by Friday, amended agendas will be coming out by Sunday. And I will verify with the village attorneys to make sure that everything I'm saying tonight is correct, because I do nothing without consulting the village attorney. Next, we did have 10 people turn in their petitions for elected officials. We have 3 people that have put their petitions in for mayor, 2 for clerk, and 5 for trustees. The filing period just started yesterday and continues through next Monday at 5 o'clock. There will be a lottery for the people that turn in the petitions before 8 o'clock so that they can go into a lottery for first position on the ballot. There will also be a lottery for the person that comes in between 4 and 5 o'clock on the following Monday. There will be a lottery that won't take place until sometime between now and December 28th. All people that are involved in the lottery will be notified, and it will be posted when the lottery will take place. There will be no meeting between now and January 2017. The 2017 meeting calendar will be posted sometime between now and the end of the month. And also, I just wanted to say that last week we had a meeting that was 2 hours long. 35 minutes of that meeting actually was village business, and an hour and 25 minutes of it was personal and political. And whatever was said that was personal and political will not be included in the minutes. And I'm not going to respond to 90% of what was said in my name. However, I am going to respond about the Veterans Center insofar as I personally did not disrupt the meeting. I personally had nothing to do with what Barb Dorman did, whether or not she offended anybody. I did personally ask the volunteers to put the information on the back table so the veterans would have it available to them. I personally saw that they had hid that information from the veterans. People who are concerned about the veterans getting everything they could possibly get at that time of year or any time of year, as far as I'm concerned, hiding the information from them was wrong. And when I told Barb Dorman that that's what they did, that's what made her get up and start passing it out. And I really hope that we don't have an entire discussion over this all over again, because we had an hour and 25 minutes worth of discussion last week. And I just wanted to say, I do care about the veterans. And what I do for the veterans, I do from my heart. The dinner that we had for the veterans was phenomenal. It is something that I will carry on. It's one of the best things I've ever done for Sauk Village. Thank you very much, Mr. Eric. Please report.
Thank you. Move to Village Ministry Director
of
Public Safety, Jim.
Mr. Mayor, with leave, I'd like to start off with Sherry Jasinski's report. I asked her to prepare for us today. Her report started with vehicle sticker total for 2015 was 2,923 stickers were sold, equalizing $85,607.50. Vehicle stickers total for 2016 as of November 16 were $2,484, were sold equaling $72,538. November collections filed equal $71,500, $750. Night court totals for December 1, 2016. 98 tickets were on the court call, 4 were found guilty, 1 not guilty, 93 were found guilty and fines doubled due to failure to appear. And we have started doing a parking patrol at Whiteland School due to complaints by residents that live in that area. People have been blocking driveways, parking on the grass, and double parking down Cynthia, Olivia, and Galen, making it nearly impossible for residents to get in and out of their driveway. From December 2 through 12, we have written 56 tickets on parking. She has filed an additional 17 liens equaling $16,561. This will complete everything that is owed to the village in the amount of $500 and up. The remainder of the liens will be on an as-needed basis dependent on payment of water bill. The village hall will be closed on December 23rd, December 26th, and Monday, January 2nd, in observation of Christmas and New Year's. She was Merry Christmas, and she said that concludes her report, but she did write an additional thing I need to report. It's about the Weatherstone estate. She said they have a new owner that wants to continue building. Currently, they have 80 lots in the second phase that have all the underground items installed and are ready to continue on with the installation of modular homes. The fees are at an increase. The old fees expired in 2007. Per the contract with the inspection agency, the fees and the ordinance that was proposed would be the cost that the village will have to reimburse Safeville. The village administrative fee is what the village will make per permit. The expansion will create more water accounts, equal more money and taxes for the village to operate. That concludes our report. Mr. Mayor, on my report on the administrator's report, I want to say that I'm starting out with 2016 water revenues. As of the end of November 2013 fiscal year to date, water revenues increased by $331,951.49. Or 21.83% over the same period a year ago. This represents a 7 straight monthly increase. Staff is to be applauded specifically for their efforts and the specific staff of Public Works and the front office staff. My next item is UCR. Uniform crime has decreased by 30% for the same period a year ago. No, it has been suggested by someone on social media that pouring a full glass of beer into an empty glass is one technique of determining annual UCR comparison. Unfortunately, beer pouring for this purpose has not yet become an exact science. But for those who are interested, I have placed the amount for the current 2013, or will be, Mr. Williams, I've asked you to put those documents out. I have placed the current 2012 through 2015 versus 2016 year-to-date UCR comparison report with methodology on the table. No, not as exciting as beer pouring, but far more accurate. Collective bargaining. As of December 6th, staff and I and the attorneys have completed all of the employees' collective bargaining agreements for Sauk Village. Completing these agreements for the betterment of the village and its employees has been a lengthy process. I'd like to thank the unions, its representatives, and staff for their effort. I would also like to thank the mayor and those trustees who voted to approve these agreements. Other business. I urge the board to approve the Weatherstone Estate Agreement. The next phase of new homes will add a sizable amount of new revenue. that will be in permits, fees, water, vehicle stickers, etc. And it will also add to their villages, in addition to an increase in their villages, equalized assessed valuation of property. Again, I would like to thank the staff for all of their effort in making this reality. And Trustee Tate, I should have your request for the engineers ready for you soon. I'll email it to you as soon as it comes in, and that is for the village boundaries. I know that this is a political season, and I know that the emotions of candidates and their workers often get tense. But I am getting tired about employees having to hear that they may or may not have a job after April based on who wins. You may or may not know that employees' rights are protected under law. So please keep politics out of village hall. I'm advising our employees to document all cases of political harassment. I will personally notify any person who undertakes such actions to cease and desist, and forward all employee complaints to the political harassment to the appropriate authority. 2016 has been a very long and but productive year in moving Sauk Village forward. I give all the credit to our employees, police department, fire department, the code enforcement people, public works, and obviously the front office staff. But I miss, and also has done what I miss anybody. Our employees have expressed to me, to you, their wishes for a safe, healthy, and happy Christmas and New Year. Mr. Mayor, that concludes my report.
Trustee Bridge. Yeah, Mr. Fairman, who owns Weatherstone? Who's the owners now?
Yeah, we'll find out. I can give you that name. I didn't write it down on this. I will give it to you. It's changed owners.
Pardon me?
It changed owners.
The reason I'm asking, how do you vote on something we don't know who they are?
I'm not in the voting process, sir. That's
what I'm asking you.
Well, that's the question best I could.
But you're asking us to vote on whoever it is that's we're increasing their or going into an agreement with them. I'd just like to know who the name of the owners are that's going to be taking over Weatherstone, and also, do they own any other property in the village?
Sauk Trail LLC.
Oh, okay, I thought maybe. And do they own anything else in the village?
Not to my knowledge.
Administrative Fairman, a couple of months ago, I raised the issue of the cell phone usage in Sauk Village. And I obtained, or I have in my possession, as you were, a outdated, it's a couple of months old, bill that we owed for cell phone usage. And it's for the period of July and August of this year. And at that time, we were delinquent $10,597. A partial payment was made, which brought the balance down to $5,300. And why I think it's a great deal of money for cell phone usage by the village. When I looked at the itemized assignment of cell phones, I see that the village has several phones which are not been assigned to anyone, but we were paying for. And I see individuals that have multiple cell phones that we're paying for. And probably most alarming, I see two employees who retired from Sauk Village who still have, or the village is still paying for their cell phones. And I'm just wondering, how is this going to be addressed, or how is it going to be addressed?
As I've stated in the past, you know, I had Public Works Director Kevin Weller to look into that. A lot of those phones he found that were not being used, he's already canceled them, and I give you an updated report. I don't have it with me right now.
And the phones that are assigned to people that are no longer employees here?
We'll find out. So I'll give you a report on all the phone numbers.
All right. Thank you very much.
Great. Move to trustees and board committees. The first one, move to Parks and Recs Committee, Trustee Jones.
Uno night has, the time has changed, well, and the name is coming in January, it will be just family night, because we're going to expand on more activities during that time. And it, the new time will be starting at 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. And that concludes my report.
Thank you, Trustee.
Welcome
to
Public
Works Committee, Trustee
Burgess. Yes, Mayor, I did not get a report, so therefore I have a report. So, all right, I'm going to pass it to you. Okay.
All right. Move to Housing and Governmental Committee, Trustee Bates.
I have no report at this time. I'm still in the process of developing a relationship with two entities to come back out and do workshops for us, and I'll provide the details at the next meeting.
Thank you, Trustee. Move to Public Safety Ordinance Review Committee, Trustee Myers.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Just a short, mostly it's going to be on safety and ordinance. I'm going to attempt to have an ordinance meeting. I will first contact my members, see if we can get together in December and see if we can get a meeting together if they're all in town or haven't left yet. Otherwise, I will have one first thing January. The second item is safety. There's a couple of things. With the cold weather coming in, I'd like to ask the mayor, are you going to have any type of cooling centers open when the temperature drops way low to the point?
Yeah, I think we'll have a warming center.
Yes, sir. Yeah. I mean, warming center.
Because it'll be too cool.
It's going to be cool enough outside.
Yeah, usually the fire chief calls me, or you, or Josh Kirk. But just so the board knows, when the weather gets below a certain degree, we open up the fire department, just so the residents know also, so that anyone whose heat goes out or anything, they can come in. We usually staff the fire department with our on-call firefighters at the fire department. And we usually do something like 6 to 6 or something.
Yes, sir.
Well, it'll be around the clock because it's already staffed from 6 to 6, and then it'll
be
6 p.m. to 6 a.m. So
it'll
just go around the clock.
Yep, so just so the board knows. So when you see the increase, it's only during winter time. So
the village administrator can send us a email. Okay, no problem. Second thing is, I'm asking help from the residents and friends. If you know a child has done this, we've experienced twice now with the snow condition it is. Young juveniles are playing games with the fire truck. Now you have about 13 tons of equipment rolling down the road, lights and siren, and they all of a sudden jump out in front of us. And on dry roads, it's hard enough to bring that rig down to a stop. On icy roads, well, we almost lost one other night because a young lad jumped out the road. We, you know, only thing you can do naturally is hit the air brakes and trust the Jones knows that's a no-no to do. And we came real close to losing that, but they brought it under control and it was down. So if you see kids playing out in the middle of the road during this icy season on the roads and stuff, please, please tell them not to do it. I hate to see somebody get hurt over a childish game. And the other thing is that we had we was on the expressway all morning this morning. We had three major accidents out there on the expressway. The last one was a 10-car pileup. Watch the bridge over the railroad track. When the temperature drops below zero, that bridge is going to be very icy. And that's where we had most of our cars. And those end up with, I believe there's six. Yeah, we have four. We transported six people to the hospital, and we had three rigs out there. It was a mess. But once again, just watch the overpass over the railroad tracks if you're using that thing when it gets below zero, because that bridge will freeze. And with that, Mr. Mayor, that's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee. We have the Watch Committee, Trustee Linda Washington House.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Just a few things. First of all, I want to thank my committee for the Christmas party that we had on last night to celebrate all of the things that we did this year, which was inclusive of a play at Rickover. Also, we had a back-to-school book bag giveaway that was a great success. the work of my committee, working hard from tagging to getting donations to make those programs happen. We had an awesome time with our guests that showed up, a lot of food, a lot of good live music. So we had a really good time last night to end our Neighborhood Watch Committee for the year. Our next meeting will be the second Monday in January. We meet every second Monday of the month at 7 o'clock at the fire station. Also, I wanted to make announcement that on this coming Saturday at the community center at 10 o'clock, if there's anyone that wanna be a deputy registrar, which means you will be able to register people to vote that are not registered to vote anywhere in Cook County, you can come and you can take that class at the community center at 10 o'clock. David Orr's office will be here doing that training. If you are already registered, if you are already a deputy registrar, all commissions expired after the presidential election. Therefore, you need to renew your commission. All you have to do is just come to the community center. You can sign the oath and you can renew your commission and walk out the door under whatever umbrella you are currently a deputy registrar for. If you know someone that's not registered to vote and they'd like to be registered to vote, they can come and register to vote Saturday at 10 o'clock as well. That would be the deputy registrar's class for, as a community service announcement. Also, I finally wanted to reiterate and I guess piggyback off of a resident's concern, because a part of Neighborhood Watch is that we do deal with no texting while driving, and we also deal with the no bullying clause that we have. I personally was attacked on this week on social media where it was indicated that I was on my way to meet with someone in a compromising position. I don't look at the Facebook pages of many people, but I was bombarded with a picture with my name in it that I was on my way to meet with a gentleman in a very compromising position. I was very upset that someone would depict me in such a character that don't even know me, don't have conversations with me. I'm a very high profile person. I'm a minister, I'm a Christian, I'm a wife, I'm a grandmother. And when they was approached, it was said to me that they said, oh, they did it, it was a joke, which was Joe Wizzlewine. I don't appreciate it. I have copies of the picture. I am showing it to community leaders. I am showing it to community pastors. I want people to be aware that you can be a victim of bullying, cyberbullying on social media by someone that thinks it's funny to say you're on your way to be promiscuous with other people just for a game. I don't like it. No one should be a recipient of it, and I'm doing everything that I can legally to pursue to the fullest extent of the law my name being used in any negative continuity just because I'm an elected official and I happen to be running in a race that's not his horse that he's bidding for. So I want to say to all of you that are victims of social media, bullying is not fun. It's not a joke when you hurt other people. It's not funny when you talk about people's wives and mothers and grandmothers. A lot of us have to experience it, but when you say openly to people, I did it for a joke, if I won't be the last one laughing. And that concludes my report.
Thank you, Trustee. Move to Budget Finance Committee, and Community Relations Committee. Trustee Rosie Williams Bay.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Just a couple of items. The Budget and Finance Committee met today. We reviewed the accounts payable, and we also discussed a couple of other items that will be more focused in the upcoming year. Also, the chief touched on it, but Shop with a Cop will be held this Thursday. I did speak with Jeremiah Johnson at the school district. Everything is finalized. I did speak with the chief today, and I know that he already thanked the police association, but I want to say thank you to Trustee Burgess for reaching out to the chief to make sure that that connection happened. We are very willing to accept that $1,000 for Shop with a Cop. And once again, that will be 10 o'clock this Thursday. Also that night is Carol Copeland Moore. I know that the village clerk did touch on that, but just as a reminder, because I know a lot of people who are in this room currently have been Carol Copeland Moore before, and the system will be different. One of the things that we had, as I stated before, we take our criticisms and take our suggestions to heart, and it was a very lengthy process for families. We did a raffle ticket when we first got in, and we pulled tickets for the toys. If you had two or three kids, your kid might have been one of the first tickets that you pulled for a toy, and then your other kid might have been one of the last kids to pull for a toy. So it was a lengthy process. We are still trying to figure out the the organization of the tables, but how we've got it in our minds there. As a family, you'll get checked in. As a family, you'll come up, you'll get your toy. As a family, you'll get your cocoa and your book. And as a family, you'll get your food basket. And as a family, you can leave. We are not doing any of the festivities that we've done in the past, like a movie or carol or reading a book. Santa will be here in the hallway Friday of the 8th. I'm not just going to regulate it to kids. For anybody who's a kid at heart who hasn't given Santa their wish list yet, Santa will be here on that night as well. But we are hoping to get enough people in, everybody served, and it's supposed to be really, really cold. So we don't want anybody to be out any more than they have to be. And that.
Thank you, Trustee.
I just picked up my messages just before the meeting, and there was a teacher from Wagner that called me to tell parents, kids about shopping coming. I'm hoping that Jeremiah Johnson took care of that sometime today. So could you please tell him to reach out, and I'll give you the name of the teacher later to remind me?
Yeah. He said he did say he spoke with all the social workers at the school, so maybe that's where the teacher is, but I'll reach out to him tomorrow.
All right, move to new business. We have a motion to approve all accounts payable and disbursements from November 9th, 2016 through December 13th, 2016, for the stockholder policies. A motion to approve.
Oh.
A motion and a second. Any questions or comments?
Question.
Trustee.
On page 2, at the top, I guess it's under elected officials and contractual services. Vendor number 1823, miscellaneous food and cutlery. What is, could anyone explain? Because it says it's elected official, so it has to be someone that was elected. I just want to know what was that or what did that pertain to? Is anyone, Mr. Fairman, do you know, or Trustee Williams, do you know anything about it? Who
that
took
was
that was Veterans Day?
Yeah, I spoke with him. That's part of the Veterans Center. We went through Sam's Club and one village has a Sam's Club card. And so that's how that came through. And then the public relations committee has to really know it.
Would that be noted so we could at least have the paperwork so it could be noted on some kind of way to show that it was reimbursed?
I don't think it would be noticed or noted until there was like an accounts receivable. But I can.
We don't have much counsel.
Right, that's what I'm saying. So we won't see it.
That's what I'm saying.
I can make a copy of the check when I write it and put it under the boxes so they can know what's up.
Right, that's all I'm saying. So it just showed that it wasn't just taken out, it was actually reimbursed. Thank you.
No problem.
And when you get a copy of the check, you're going to get a copy of the receipt that I took something back that we did not use.
And
I'll make sure that that's all
checked. Well, yeah. That makes sense. Yeah.
Question?
Trustee.
On page 4, under general fund, 22 of like, Allen, reimbursement for food, $223. And 87 says, you know what that was?
Yes, Trustee Martin, you want to tell them that's what he posted. That's what, as the host is an angle.
On the bottom?
Yes.
All right. On the reason I know what it's for, and I've attended a couple of their sessions over the many years I've been in talk of it. It's the organization of emergency services and management, and once they rotate to different towns to have their and their meeting, and this time Sauk was their time to host the training session and everything. It's the annual thing that they do. Now next month it'll go over to another town. They keep going all over around the circle. I think Sauk gets it. I guess it's twice a year that we end up hosting. I know I've been to several of the training sessions that they have sandwiches and a refreshment afterwards. That's for all the as the Homeland Security and smart people in the entire South Suburban. And they get a pretty good turnout. That's the only reason I know what it's about.
Thank you. I have some more questions, but I'll talk to Mohan.
Excuse me?
I said thank you. I have more questions, but I will talk to Mohan.
But you'll be here tomorrow.
Any other questions? Trustee Jones.
Page one. Skyline, Republic Service, garbage fees. I was wondering for what we paid, is this what we were billed for?
Yes.
Jones?
Yes.
Myers?
Yes.
Tate?
No.
Motion to adopt?
Yes.
Yes.
Motion carries. We will try item number B. Motion to approve special meeting minutes for November 8th, 2016. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
And motion is there a second?
Second.
Any questions or comments? Okay, now go to Trustee Sauk.
Jones?
No.
Myers?
Yes.
Tate?
No.
Washington House?
Yes.
Lewis Gladys? Yes. Burgess?
No.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes. Motion carries. Item C, motion to approve board meeting minutes for November 8th, 2016. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second.
Motion and second. Any questions or comments? Hearing none, please follow.
Myers?
Yes.
Tate?
No.
Washington House?
Yes.
Williams Bay? Yes. Burgess?
No.
Jones?
No.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes. Motion carries. Item D, motion to approve executive session meeting minutes for November 8th, 2016. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second.
Yeah, motion second. Any questions or comments? Hearing none, vote short, please follow.
Tate?
No.
Washington House?
Yes.
Williams Bay? Yes. Burgess?
No.
Jones?
Yes.
And Mr. Myers?
Yes.
Motion carries. Item E, motion to approve special meeting minutes for December 6th, 2016. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Yeah, motion is there second.
Sorry.
Yeah, motion second. Any questions or comments? Hearing none, vote short, please follow.
Washington House?
Yes.
Williams Bay? Yes.
Burgess?
No.
Jones?
No.
Myers?
Yes.
Tate?
No.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes, motion carries. Item F, motion to approve and hold executive session meeting minutes for December 6th, 2016. Is there a motion to approve?
So
yeah, motion is there a second?
Second.
Yeah, motion is second. Any questions or comments?
Question.
Trustee.
I think this is the one that I talked to the clerk about, and I'm not going to vote until I see that it's been changed. It was something on that minutes that needs to be added to. So as it's written right now, I would not vote on it.
I inform Trustee Burgess that that's exactly what was said in the minutes. I will put it in the minutes. Otherwise, I would add a note that he requested that that be part of the record. But I can only put in the minutes what's stated in on the tape. But I will review that. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Motion second. Any other questions or comments? Hearing none, please follow. Yes.
Williams Bay?
Yes.
Burgess?
No.
Jones?
Yes.
Myers?
Yes.
Tate?
No.
Washington House?
Yes.
Motion carries. Item G, motion to approve committee meeting minutes for December 6, 2006. Yeah, motion is there a second?
Second.
Yeah, motion is second. Any questions or comments? Trustee Burgess.
What I had asked for, and I think it should have been in the minutes, is item number four for about tax levy. Yeah, I think we can bring it up when the tax levy comes, but I did, at that particular meeting, ask for a breakdown as far as how did they come up, what type of formula did they use, or what was used to distribute the funds.
I believe in the minutes it does say that the finance director,
I believe, I don't have it in front of me, but it says that the finance director, Mohan, will be asked to give you that formula. I can only put in the minutes what is stated at that time. Now, finance director Rao, it's his responsibility upon somebody's direction to give you that formula. But in the minutes, I believe it does say that he would be requested to give that formula to you and all trustees.
All right, any other questions or comments?
Come in.
Just
Was it on the last page to break down? Was it on the last page? Because he did send a child home. It was the exact same thing that was on the last page.
Trustee was asking for something else. He wanted to know how the formula was derived and how. Right.
Okay.
All right, any other questions or comments? Okay, no, please call the roll.
Burgess?
Yes.
Jones? Myers?
Yes.
Hicks? Westinghouse?
Yes.
Williams-Bennett?
Yes.
Okay, motion carries. Item H, motion to approve. Ordinance approving intergovernmental agreement to establish a joint 911 authority between the Village of Cayman Park, the Village of Sauk Village, and the Village of Midlothian, and the Village of Posen. Joint 911 authority, IGA, is there a motion to approve?
Uh-oh.
And motion is there a second?
Second.
And motion is second. Any questions or comments? Trustee Tate.
To the board, the last time we discussed the 911, I indicated that there were some things that I think we should have done in this agreement. One of those to talk to the Sauk Village 911 people to find out and get their input before entering the agreement, because they're the experts on this issue. The second was to find out any assets and response and liabilities that that board had. And we collectively decided not to do either of those. I personally think that we should have done all three to find out what we're getting into before we did it. That did not happen. The second part is that we've had two presentations about this 911 board. At one of the trustees brought up the state statute, which identified things that were totally different than what we were told. And he was told it's going to be changed. I think we should be careful about entering all these agreements without knowing what we're entering into. As you heard during the presentations, nothing's in place. They don't know how many people are on the board. They don't know anything except the mayor appoints everyone to participate. But other than that, there were several questions asked at both sessions and no answers were provided to them. So I just wanted to say that this board is entering into something and you don't really know what you're entering into because there are too many loopholes that have not been filled as of yet. So without proper and complete information, I just think it's a dangerous thing to do. That's all I say.
I think the trustee, I should make sure the board is well aware. Number one, we already have an intergovernmental agreement between the Village of Cayman Park and Village of Sauk Village in Midlothian. This is adding Posen, so this agreement here is adding another community to this joint 911. And again, this is so that for the state board. So this is just updating with the new community. All right, any other questions or comments? Here you go, Bill Short, please call the roll.
Jones?
No.
Myers?
Yes.
Hicks?
No.
Westinghouse?
Yes.
Williams-Bennett?
Yes.
Burgess?
No.
Mr.
Yes, motion carries. Item I, motion to approve an ordinance for a tax levy and assessment of taxes for the 2016-2017 fiscal year for the Georgia Sauk Village, County of Smith and Will. Is there a motion to approve?
Uh-huh.
Motion is there a second?
Second.
And motion is second. Any questions or comments?
Question.
Trustee Burgess.
When can we...
Question.
Bless you.
Question.
When can we get... When can we expect to get a breakdown? I mean, we're going to levy X amount of money. I just wanted to know how do we come to those, which I repeated before, last week. How do we come to those totals? And to vote on something to levy, to keep levying, I asked this before. What are we going to do with the money other than just throw it into the pot and do as you may? I thought maybe if you levy, you're levying for a reason. You're levying to build something, to do something other than just pay bills and get raises. So that's what I reason why I wanted to find out what we were doing and how each department got what they got. So in that case, you know, that's what I asked. Well, I was hoping I would get an answer between last week and this week, but that's all I have.
All right, thank you, trustee. Any other questions or comments? If you're not going to short, please call the roll.
Myers?
Yes.
Hicks?
No.
Washington House?
Yes.
Williams-Bennett?
Yes.
No.
No.
Mayor Burchett. Motion carries. Item J, motion to approve an ordinance authorizing entry of an agreement with Sauk Trail LLC regarding permit fees at Weatherstone Estates. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
A motion, is there a second?
Second.
A motion, a second. Any questions or comments? Hearing none, Madam Clerk, please call roll.
Thanks.
No.
Washington House?
Yes.
Williams-Dyke?
Yes.
Purchase?
No.
Jones?
Yes.
Ambrose?
Yes.
Motion carries. Item K, motion to approve resolution for construction on state highways. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Got a motion, is there a second? Got a motion, a second. Any questions or comments? Hearing none, Madam Clerk, please call roll.
Tates?
No.
Washington House?
Yes.
Williams-Dyke?
Yes.
Purchase?
Yes.
Jones?
Yes.
Myers?
Yes.
Motion carries. Item L, motion to approve an ordinance adopting an expense reimbursement policy in accordance with the Local Government Travel Expense Control Act, Public Act 099-0604. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Motion, is there a second?
Second.
Your motion, a second. Any questions or comments?
Question.
Trustee Burgess.
Who made the maximum amount? Is that coming from the state, or is that something that was just inserted, the maximum travel expense amount? Because I never seen that before. I'm just wondering who arrived at that? Is that the state, or is that the federal, or was it just someone inserted that? Because I've never seen as many times as we went away what a maximum amount would be for travel expense.
It was recommendation by the village attorneys when they put this together. There was a couple spots that were opened, and that was one of the amounts that was open for a municipality to put in there. What they did is look at other surrounding communities and other ordinances that were passed for that amount. Again, if we want to amend it at a later time, we can amend it. But again, it was something that he could get before us, so at least we could have something passed before January 1st, which is when it comes into effect.
And Mayor, when do we get this? I mean, yes, the other day? Reason why I'm asking, I mean, because we're passing something that we never got a chance to discuss. We saw it, but you gave it, you said this is what we're gonna have. This is what's going to come up. But to actually sit back and discuss this, and now we're asking to vote on it, and I just wanted to know where those, because I never saw numbers before. I always saw that, yes, you had to submit bills, yes, you had to, you know, get reimbursed, but it was never a maximum or a minimum amount. And I was just wondering, how did that come to be? And at least we could have had a chance to discuss it, because this way we would kind of know. But to vote on this tonight and not have a chance to discuss it, I think we should, you know. But you're stating we have to have this by January 1st, and we're not having another meeting until January. So that's why I was wondering why we couldn't have discussed this before. But
I think what we have before us is an ordinance that if it's passed, we can always come back in January, we can make amendments. However, at least we have an ordinance on the books before January 1st. Again, that's why, number one, when it came to my attention, it was too late to put it on the agenda last week. That's why I passed everything out there in the mayor's report. That's why I was giving a heads up to everyone. We forwarded our expense policy to those attorneys. They took a look at it. They added, based off what the state is mandating. I think one thing to make sure that everyone understands too, the only ones that's affected by this travel policy is non-home rural communities. Home rural communities are not affected by it. So it came across pretty quick, and that's the reason it's before us.
Well, I would like to, I mean, that's something that we need to discuss, because right away, the way it looked at it, everybody when we go away, would be affected by the maximum amount, as you can see.
Correct. You're correct.
Mr. Mayor.
Justice.
Couple questions.
Yes.
If it's already been public act voted on and everything, it's a public act, what are we doing? We're just accepting it as a ordinance, or is that what the purpose for the ordinance is?
It was passed in Springfield, it's mandated that the municipalities, especially non-home rural communities, have to have the ordinance in place. They had guidelines by the ordinance. One good thing is we had our own ordinance. There was just a few things that had to be changed. We were a little bit proactive a few years back when we passed our own ordinance.
All right, so this will take effect immediately?
Yes, because it has to be on your books before January 1st.
And this also will grow across the village I mean, trustee, department heads, and anybody that spend money and wants reimbursement has to pull this thing out.
Correct. So, and you're supposed to anyway for any expense. We use it a lot for travel expense, for going to conferences, things like that. Right. So, which we already have an expense policy or expense report and turned into the finance director, along with the receipts.
I agree, but ours definitely need to be updated, but this one here covers quite a bit. It covers it pretty good. Okay, thank you.
Yes, sir. Any other questions or comments? Hey, none, go short, please call roll.
Yes.
Yes.
Burgess?
No.
Jones?
No.
Myers?
Yes.
Tate?
No.
Mr. Mayor?
Shit, I'm going to yes. It's tempting to go. All right, move time number 7. This line is comments from the Mayor Board of Trustees. Start with Trustee Burgess tonight.
Start this way. Okay, I just wanted to, I didn't get a chance to last week to thank everyone that came out to the Veterans Celebration. It was a success, even though it was interrupted. And I was asked, I'm gonna set everything straight right now so we can keep this back and forth not going and all this name and everything else. I was asked right before the celebration began to ask the veterans at some time to invite them to the dinner. A dinner that was going to be held for the veterans. I told the clerk, yes, I would announce that. I didn't say when, but I said I would announce it. And the program went on. During that program, halfway through it is when the commotion started, because I guess I didn't do it quick enough. I wasn't going to stop the program. I was going to wait until the end like we do with any other program and make the announcements. But that wasn't afforded me, so then we just had this disruption. And I'm sorry that it happened that way, because it shouldn't have. I mean, this is, you know, I'm grown enough to know when to insert announcements, and announcements are to be inserted at the time announcements should be inserted, which would be at the end of any program like we have at the Village Hall meeting. So I'm hoping that this doesn't throw a damper. I understand that there were some things written in the paper or whatever, but I put this out for a long time. The paper didn't even put out the fact that we had a Veterans Dinner celebration for the third year in a row. That was never even put in the paper, but it was reported that it wasn't announced. It was reported that the Veterans Dinner that was held later was never mentioned. That part was. It's just a shame that, you know, we have to, as this was stated before us, and it's stated again by the mayor, we have to be political when it comes to informing the residents here in the village. I mean, we're here, this is Sauk Village. This is not somebody's Sauk Village. So this is Sauk Village. This is for the residents, and at this particular one, it's for the veterans. So I'm sorry that happened, but there shouldn't be no one standing and walking around doing a celebration, doing a program, trying to talk about their own program. I was asked to do it. Obviously, I didn't do it quick enough, so therefore, that's what happened. Then, but we still heard about that. That was in November 11th. So that's a month ago, and we're still hearing about it. It's something that it happens. Unfortunate that it happened, but you know, to continue to keep talking about, is that going to change anything? No, not going to change anything. Also, I just want to wish everyone a Merry Christmas, and I guess we won't see you guys until New Year's. Stay warm, enjoy your family, enjoy your life. You only have one, and go visit the elderly if you can. If you like to, you know, go visit some of the senior citizens, residents, see how they're doing, because it is cold out there. That's all I have there.
Thank you, Trustee. Trustee Washington.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I just want to reiterate that we will be having our deputy registers class on Saturday at 10 o'clock. If you're not a deputy registrant, you want to be one, or if you know someone that needs to be registered to vote, they can come. Also, I want to encourage all of the residents that are here in the rotunda, as well as those that are viewing by the videos that's going to be posted, that it is never okay for you to allow people to treat you poorly. It is never okay for you to allow people to treat you disrespectfully. I sat here in this rotunda when a gentleman was being appointed by the mayor to fulfill a vacancy. He was making an appointment, and there was information disseminated on every single row in this rotunda about an appointee that was being appointed that night. It was degrading for him, it was embarrassing for him, but they passed it out and nobody said anything about it. And it was a shameful what was written and what was done right here in this village hall. They went row by row and passed out information about a person being appointed by the mayor, about his personal background or whatever, in this rotunda while a meeting was going on. So I have seen people being disrupted while meetings are going on by passing out literature. But it's just a shame that it's okay if some people do it, and if other people have programs and people pass out information doing their programs, it's a big travesty. But nevertheless, I think we should all be equal and we should all treat people the way that we want to be treated. And with that, have a Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Trustee. Trustee Jones.
Happy holidays, and I'll see you next year.
Trustee Tate.
The police chief casually mentioned something earlier that I was going to bring up because I came into possession of a document from the Office of the Attorney General, which talked about grants that we received here in Sauk Village, and some dating back to 1999. It also mentioned that we received $18,500 in February of last year. And it was for benefit of our law enforcement personnel. And the chief and I had raised this issue once before, and the chief gave a partial answer. And it's because I think we take for granted and don't do enough to protect our law enforcement personnel. And if we receive grants in order to protect them as they do their job, and we get something else with the money, which it appears may have happened, then I think that's a travesty. I don't think we're doing what we are supposed to do as a community to safeguard the first responders. In this case, our law enforcement personnel. We're not doing enough to protect them as they protect us. So if we have all these grants coming in and no one can say how the money was spent, where it was spent, why it was spent, but we know one thing for sure, that it was not spent for the intended purpose. And you can look at when our law enforcement personnel were providing protective equipment, and you will see for yourself. Now, thanks to the chief in the back, he did mention to me, or us actually, during a meeting, he mentioned the life of some of this equipment. And if you look at the roster, you'll see that some of this equipment is beyond the expiration date. And it should not be beyond the expiration date if we kept track of everything we're doing, and if we use money, when we put in for grants, those grants are for specific purposes. If it's for lighting, that's what the grant's for. It's for lighting. It's not for carpet. So we should be using money that we say is for our law enforcement personnel. We should be using it appropriately. And thanks to the chief, I appreciate you giving me that information. Unfortunately, I came in possession of this information from the Office of the Attorney General, which asked more questions than I had asked, and still the village has not, to my knowledge, responded to how, since 1999, we have utilized the money that we received in grants for our law enforcement personnel. So I want them to be safe. Be safe on the streets, and God be with you.
Trustee Marsh.
This is a Christmas holiday and so forth. I want each and every one of you to keep your ears open. There's a song, and it's a holiday song. The name of it, This Is a Soldier Home. Listen to that song. Santa goes down the chimney, and the first thing he says, this is a home of a soldier. Listen to what he says after that. People, that's what it's all about. These young men, some of them gave their life up for us. Enough saying bad things about them. Each and every one. You see a soldier out there, you know he's a veteran or a soldier. Walk up to him and shake his hand. Thank you. That's what it's all about. These kid, when you first go in, you're 18 years old, and you go through a lot of training, but that's what it's all about. You should quit talking bad about them, praise them, shake their hands. And with that note, I just want to wish each and every one of you a very Merry Christmas, and please, please have a very safe New Year's Eve. Be careful.
Thank you. Over the past week, I was informed of some comments that were made by me, and I'm gonna be respectful to this individual, Mr. Wisbuddy, unlike you or me. So I was informed of some comments that you personally made about my physical appearance and your supposed knowledge of my religion, stating that I am, and I quote, an admitted agnostic, anti-Christian woman who couldn't give a damn about people, who is more interested in stuffing her face as if it is self-evident, who openly ridiculed kids for being stupid and could care less about Christian values of feeding the hungry, clothing the naked, or sheltering the homeless. Following down in that letter that you wrote, you called the village clerk the village jerk. You called me, her baby, the know-it-all trustee, and calling multiple times to take out the trash, referring to the village clerk and that, stating that I have no religious beliefs. I wanted to say a couple things about that. Number one, as far as for calling the kids stupid, as you put in there, I never did that. If you refer back to the tapes that you have taped, if you would like to pull the minutes or even the tapes of the village clerk, you will see that I stated that the teachers, it appeared to me that the teachers helped the kids write the essays because they were all the same. If you're looking for the trustee that talked about their intelligence level, that would be Trustee Tate's, not me. And I would ask you to refer back to that tape. As far as regarding my appearance, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. I may not feel the same way about you that you feel about yourself, and that's okay. But if I'm comfortable with myself, and my husband is comfortable with myself, I will ask that you keep my appearance out of your mouth and off of your words. Secondly, regarding my anti-Christian values, last Saturday, I participated in a program that I participated in for the last 17 years. I gave it to you, I'm sure everybody in this room knows, I've been a trustee for 11 and a half, so don't think that I'm doing anything because I'm a trustee. I participated in a program for the last 17 years called the Angel Team. At that organization, we collect gifts throughout the year, gifts of warmth and gifts of fun. Whether it's books, toys, games, anything like that, for the homeless people of Chicago and the surrounding areas. Now, you may not be paying attention or you may not realize that this is true, but if you have any questions, I would refer you to Beth Zupan, who every year up until this year has donated toothbrushes and toothpaste to this organization to give out to the homeless people of Chicago and the surrounding areas. Also, regarding with the anti-Christian values and the name calling, we want to talk about anti-Christian values. However, you've called me multiple names in this post and as well as other posts, and it's just not isolated to myself and the village clerk. I know that Trustee Washington House mentioned that she commented some things on her. I know that there's some audience members that you got that too as well. So, because we're talking about Christian values, I would like to refer to you to the Bible. Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verses 12 through 14. Words from the mouth of the wise are gracious, but fools are consumed by their own lips. At the beginning, their words are folly. At the end, they are wicked, madness, and fools multiply words. No one tells, no one knows what is coming. Who can tell someone what has happened after them? Again, Matthew chapter 5, verse 22. But I say to you that anyone who is angry with a brother will be subjected to judgment. And whoever insults a brother will be brought before the council. And whoever says fool will be sent to a fiery hell. When you want to talk about Christian beliefs, and you're saying that I don't have any, implying that you do, go back to your book, sir.
Yeah, my book.
And go back to the book that you claim to have and understand that if you're following, if you're telling me that I don't have Christian views, follow your own and understand that just because you have keeper of court courage does not make you a good person. Thank you very much. I would also suggest, I know that Trustee Birch has stated it again tonight, he stated it last week, I would hope that as 2007 progresses, that we are kinder and gentler with each other. The need for name calling is so childish and petty, it's ridiculous. And I know that it's an election year, and if that's how people think that they need to win an election, I would suggest that you choose a different route. Because you're not gonna hear it from me. I'm not gonna call you any names. I'm giving you the respect to speak to you personally and to your face. I don't need to go on the keyboard and type a bunch of stuff about you because I'm an adult. And lastly, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, and Happy New Year. And that's all I have.
Wow. Man, am I gonna miss all this? You know, it's we can go off at so much here. There's gonna be things that's gonna be said. You know, just so everyone that you have to take things that are said, especially on social media, and grade us off. You just have to sometimes consider the source. You know, and the old saying, you know, you talk about the Bible says in the book of Matthew, the book of Luke, not to judge now. So judge not.
Yes, you
should not be judged. So, again, it's on election year, and as I say, we've got quite a few months left, so. All I can say is, Lord, help us, and Lord, help us our village. Mr. Griswold, you've received a lot of press tonight. I'm surprised you're not running for office. Let's see here. The grants, it was mentioned tonight. I think everyone should realize that, especially with any type of grant that you receive, there's documentation paperwork that has to be filled out, especially if grants are made for to the village for certain things. So, you know, we'll have a look into it. I mean, there was an accusation tonight by one of the trustees about grants that were made. I think it's funny to go back to 1999. So we'll look into that. We talked about it earlier, and I think everyone's touched on politics tonight. Just about every trustee, maybe not Trustee Myers, but. You look at Sauk Village, and I think we have some probably heated conversations. We all get passionate about what we're doing up here. Nothing wrong with that. Trustees have a right to vote the way they vote. But I was reading an article this morning on Harvey, Illinois. And you think Sauk Village is in bad shape. Harvey, I think it was April, if I remember right, four of their trustees stopped attending board meetings. Pretty much put that village to a complete halt. Now, while things are still moving here, as of right now, things are still moving. We're able to break ties. We're able to make payroll. We're able to do things like that. Can you imagine being a municipality where four-year trustees don't show up and don't have a quorum? Nothing's getting paid. Nothing's getting done. So, I don't look bad on trustees the way they vote. Sometimes I wish they would look a little bit more into it. Maybe come talk to me, but it's up to them. They don't have to talk to me. They don't have to like me. It's up to them. So, the next thing is, you don't want to think of it, see if we get pockets. So, okay, before next year. All right. Let's see here. The fire department pancake breakfast. Okay, if you missed it, you missed a great time. Took the family. Had my daughter do a selfie of us all there eating, so I had some great food. And every year, I had great food. I have to be honest with you, I have a hard time eating pancakes. I love eating pancakes, but they make me sick. But I have to eat a pancake every time I go. The bad thing is it's on Sundays. So I'm trying to stay away from Sunday mornings in church after eating a pancake. That just really just drains me. But I tell the board it's the fire department's fault. Trustee Myers, you tell those guys it's their fault that I fall asleep in church on Sunday. Sunday school. I was awake during Sunday service. Let's see here. The expense policy before us tonight. I'm glad it was passed. And again, I was tempted to vote no, but I have to think of our employees. Because our employees are still taking training, they're still turning in expenses. If I would have voted no, it would have been to next year before it came back to the board. There's other things that's involved in this, and there's something under state statute. If it wasn't passed before January 1st, there's like 180 days before the expense policy comes into place after January 1st. We're looking into it. So, and the importance was getting it passed tonight. So. I couldn't imagine having our village employees, if we waited to January, come back waiting six months before they could put in a expense policy. So that's why it did take a little bit of time. I was going to vote no, but I decided not to. The last thing is, again, it's our last meeting for the year, but wish everyone a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thank you very much. Ask for a motion to adjourn. Yeah, motion and second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Meeting adjourned.